Hello, this is CJ with CompRCC.com, and in this series of videos, I'm going to be assembling a Team Losi 22 short course truck. Getting ready to assemble the front suspension, a couple of the aftermarket parts I'm adding to this kit are going to come into play here. The first is the 5-degree caster blocks. The stock ones are a 10-degree caster block. Certainly not going to throw these away. I'm making these changes to the 5-degree caster block, and I'm just going to switch to 5-degree less kick because that gives better performance on very high grip tracks like clay and indoor carpet, which are the two environments I'm going to be racing in at this time of the year. This summer, when a lot of stuff moves outdoors and I'm going to be, you know, racing on much looser, loamier surfaces, these guys are going to come back out, and likewise, swapping back to a 30-degree front plate. I'm just going to set these guys aside. There's one other change that's going on here, and this is for strength. The way this assembles goes like so, and then from either end, these pins here, that they're threaded and then smooth with an assortment of spacers, these thread in from above and below and provide the pivoting action. So you've got an empty space there. These trinitride coated front kingpins, they're threaded at either end and they pass through like so, and it should be fairly obvious how much stronger that's going to be instead of having a pin that goes partway through at either side, having these pins pass all the way through, and it really doesn't add much in the way of unsprung weight. So I thought that was a worthwhile upgrade as well. This is another instance where I'm going to be using the aluminum spacers. And that yields a very nice smooth action there. Now I'm going to go ahead and pause the video and complete the assembly on the other side. Now we get out our swing arms. There's one side. I'm going to pause the video and move on to the next. Now it's time to build up the turnbuckles. I'm going to do this off screen, as it were. I'm going to go ahead and pause the video, build these up. Most of you have certainly built turnbuckles before. If you haven't, I'm going to have a separate video online about building up turnbuckles. Now that my turnbuckles are assembled, it's time to start putting the front end together. And we have these kingpins for the left and right. Front metal brace, and there's a pair of little set screws. You're going to use a 1.5 millimeter wrench, and those screw into these little holes on either side. Now, when those go in, they're going to go into this little bevel in the kingpin, and that's going to keep that kingpin from coming out. When the kingpin goes through, that set screw is going to go into that little slot, and that will keep this pin from coming out. So now it's time to put in the set screws. And this is not something you're going to want to over-tighten, because you don't want to strip the threads. And you'll feel it when it makes contact. There's our front swing arms. Now we're going to attach our control rods and just pop them on. Takes a little bit of effort. And that's all there is to that. So I'm going to go ahead and do the other three. Now remember, as I mentioned, there is a mark which gives you left versus right. Put that mark facing the same direction on all sides, and all the turnbuckles will tighten and loosen with the wrench in the same direction. So now it's time to put on the shock tower, but I just want to demonstrate something. This is a testament to just how good Losi's kits are, how well engineered everything is. You may or may not be able to see this. I'm holding the suspension in place, and there is no play in this front hub. It's very stable, and yet there's no stiction whatsoever. It's totally free-flowing, and that's exactly what you want. This is a very well-engineered kit. I'm very pleased. It's probably best to follow the recommendation for the initial location of the shock absorber upper mounts.